I'm very certain that for most Ghanaian students, GHS, SHS, we don't look forward to science class, mathematics. And that's because it's very difficult to reconcile what they're teaching you with exactly what's on the ground. Sometimes you just have to imagine what your, you know, teacher is trying to teach you. And it's so difficult because you don't understand what they're trying to say. You know, for instance, telling you that we are converting kinetic energy to magnetic energy and all those jargons. Well, guess what? GH for STEM, you know, a campaign is ongoing just to make it easier for our little brothers and sisters in both GHS and SHS. And I've been joined in studio by a lady and a gentleman. Dr. Thomas Tego is a co-founder for GH Scientific Partner. He's a partner on the project. And we all know Nash Oko, presenter, entrepreneur, TV and radio show host. She's the voice for the project. Good morning, gentlemen.
Hi, Etana.
Hello.
Good to have you here. You know, I did science in school. I did physics, chemistry, biology, and elective maths. Okay. And I didn't look forward to especially the physics class because I was wondering what are they discussing? You know, I can't understand what's happening. So all you had to do was to memorize. Yeah. You pass your exams and you are off. You know, you're a doctor. Did you have such challenge?
No. If I said I did, you know, my students would now be wondering. Yeah. But I think physics is one of those that a lot of students like. Mm-hmm. I'm okay with biology. I'm okay with chemistry.
Yeah, but biology physics, you can understand, but physics, it was tough.
Indeed, but I think this is part of the reason why we are on this campaign, because as tough as it is, there are ways around it, and ways that don't necessarily require the usual heavy investment build, so much labs and so on. There are ways around it. And as we go and we tell you about this campaign, you realize that we found a very good way.
So GH for STEM, what does it mean? What does the GH stand for, and then the 4, and then the STEM?
Okay, great. So GH,
Ghana.
4, because we couldn't write F-O-R, you have to be in with the lingo. So 4, the number.
Okay.
And then STEM, S-T-E-M, standing for science, technology engineering,
and maths. Okay. Yeah. Okay, and this campaign, what is it about?
Right, so the GH for STEM campaign is really a campaign we have all embarked on, alongside NAC as well. To really showcase what students in GHS and SHS can do experimentally. So what it is over the last 2 years, we've been traveling around the whole country, 100 different schools. We've shot 100 different videos of GHS and SHS students doing very exciting experiments. So for physics, like this, there's a school we went to somewhere in the Western region where a student actually created a light bulb. So you look back to the earliest experiments when they teach you about what happens when you pass an electric current through whatever, and the theory behind how the first light bulb was created. She did all of this in under 5 minutes on camera, which is recorded for you to see, and she explained the whole process. Now imagine something like that then being made available to anyone else around the country to watch and see. It wouldn't be so confusing now to see how a light bulb works.
And this for you, Nash Oko, how does it work for you? Are you able to understand this, you know? I mean, you are a TV presenter, radio presenter, and an entrepreneur, for instance. How did you get to believe this GH for STEM?
Well, I've always been an advocate for good quality education, especially for our brothers and sisters in the public schools. So when I heard about this campaign and I heard it was education related and it was for students in GHS, I got interested. We Go Innovate is the owner of this initiative.
Yes,
they're called We Go Innovate. They're an edutech platform, and they're here to just serve for almost no money at all, because they're doing this absolutely out of pocket. So when I heard about the campaign, I was excited, because like you, in GHS, I was the master of chew and pour. All right, you can just say whatever, diffusion, osmosis, I'll just give you the definition, pop, 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 pop,
but I don't even understand what I'm saying.
A straight A, but I never, honestly, I never really understood these concepts practically. It was just good for my exams, and that was it. So the GH for STEM campaign really is a call to promote the acceleration of practical STEM education in GHS and SHS. So instead of just reading a black and white textbook, we are saying, okay, so it's possible to create or to generate electricity from potatoes. So you need 5 potatoes, you put these potatoes down. In fact, these students weren't told what to do, right? There are things that they have learnt in theory, which they haven't had
the opportunity to practicalize. To
And like Thomas said, the investment in science labs and so on is a deterrent for a lot of schools to want to have practical STEM education. But what GH for STEM is doing is using very simple things in your environment for these experiments. So for example, these kids are using used water bottles, like a mineral water bottle. They cut it in half. They use it as a beaker. They are using their empty pen cases as pipettes to do these experiments.
So these are instruments you're used to, like a pen.
Just things in your environment. So you don't need all the fancy science apparatus to understand science. And you know, this is the new age for science. Really, around the world, we see children in China doing amazing things. And we're here still chewing and pouring. So it's a problem. And maybe I'm more passionate about it now because I have children. And I feel, you know what, we need the best of education for these kids. So all we're saying is we're asking pretty much all parents, teachers, all Ghanaians to come on board this GH for STEM campaign. Already GAST, GH Scientific, the Ghana STEM Network, Exploratory and so on are propagating practical STEM education. But what GH for STEM brings on board are these audiovisuals. You know the importance of audiovisual in learning. If you can see it, then you'll believe it more. We've seen children learning about computers with a drawing on a blackboard. That's a problem. So if you
they
can
see it
your
and touch it and feel it
doing it.
Yeah.
I watched an experiment with a child building a balloon boat, which explains how a boat floats on the ocean. Until then, I had no idea. I just knew that, okay, maybe it's made of some substance
that makes it float.
But I saw John Dumelo, so we have some of our celebrities doing our experiments. John Dumelo did a little experiment which explains how a submarine works, and it was so exciting.
Very exciting.
So I tried to do it at home. Let me tell you, I'll tell you later. So all of these just bring our minds to the fact that practical STEM education promotes or whips up practical or critical thinking in children. You know, it provides them problem-solving skills. So with a child that did the bulb, we have a big lights, you know, electricity problem in Ghana. But we can, from watching that experiment only, I know that, okay, so light is not only generated from hydro, you know, electric power. You can use a potato to light a bulb in your house. Or maybe you can use yam, I don't know. But the more children do these,
the more
they ideas they get, and the more innovative they become.
Because, you know, the winners of the just, you know, ended the National Science and Math Quiz, we were told that when they came back, they said, you know what, we are very far behind. When we traveled outside the country, saw that when it comes to Ghana, all we do is memorize. You know, we can't really understand what we're reading. We are just memorizing. And I'm told this is a competition. How does it work? It's a competition?
Yes.
How does it work?
So the way it works is I have all these students, like I said, from over 100 schools we've recorded, and then they've all done these experiments, which they've chosen to do. It's all been videoed, and we're going to get it on TV.
Okay.
So that when people watch, whichever one you like the most, you can then sort of like vote on it. Like, like we do, for many years, we've all been complaining about these competitions being your beauty pageants and things like that. Well, here's an opportunity, an education lined up one.
So you have how many schools? All 100 schools?
100 schools,
So we have 100 students from 100 schools, 65% of them being girls, by the way. And the girls had the best experiments, by the way. Well, we're calling for more girls to be educated
and be interested
and be
in
interested
science
in
related
STEM. So it was very exciting for me to know that the girls, because you go to some of the regions and all the teachers are men. And you wonder where the girls are. So it's great to see that the girls are doing these experiments, very exciting experiments. They're so articulate and they're so good. And just by watching them, you can replicate this at home. And you can do it. And they have real life applications to these too. So aside doing the experiment, they tell you how it works in real life. So we're doing this way, but then this is how it works in real life. So when you learn about, I don't know if it's diffusion or osmosis, our teachers would not even use one can of, what do you call it, deodorant and spray in one corner.
Say that this is diffusion. You know, they're just telling you to memorize. This is what diffusion means.
They just memorize. They could have just used a deodorant to show us, you know, what one level of higher concentration or lower concentration or whatever it is.
Or even osmosis.
Exactly.
I think sometimes the reason was
we have really struggled.
Not all the teachers may quickly know what experiments you need to do that. Mm-hmm. So with this, it's now providing some like resources, which can then become teaching and learning materials in every other classroom. Because you'll see a teacher in the Northern region, you see what experiment they did, and you are teaching somewhere in the Volta region, you see it, you realize, oh snap, I can do this to teach this concept. Yes. And it's a very good sharing.
When is it starting? When is the competition starting?
Well, we roll out on the 7th of March.
7th of March.
Yes. So as the videos...
This year?
Yes.
Okay.
In a couple of weeks.
Okay.
So as the videos come out, they're going to be available for all teachers and all students to watch.
Will it be on a particular network or will be on YouTube?
We're still working on that. Okay. So we currently have some TV stations which will show it.
Okay.
We'll show some as full TV shows and some as fillers on TV. So in between New Day, you can just show a bit of our video. Just so that children watching at home and parents can have a hands-on approach to learning science.
And then we get to vote for whoever.
Yes.
And then what are the prizes?
Well, we're hoping that all of our prizes will be opportunities in STEM. Outside of Ghana, so they can go and come and then bring us, because we know what other children are doing around the world. We have to also tap into that.
Nashoko, thank you so much. Nashoko is a voice for GH for STEM, and Dr. Thomas Tego is a co-founder, GH Scientific, is a partner on the project GH for STEM. I'm excited about this campaign. I can't wait for us to practicalize what we've been learning at school regarding science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.